Hello friends, welcome back to Zero Math. Right now what you are seeing on the screen is a previous year question from SSC CPO exam. This is a question related to simplification and you are given four options which are quite close to each other. This is one of the typical question asked in many competitive exam. However, this question is a bit different. I'll come to that later. Here the basic challenge is not whether you will solve this question or not. The challenge is whether you can solve this question in least possible time, and that is precisely what we are going to learn in this video. Let's quickly get into the solution. Let me place this question to the right hand side. Yeah, now we'll solve it. Generally, these type of questions are very typical questions from exam. So what happens in such form of question? In numerator, you have term like a square plus b square or a cube plus b cube. In this case, it is a cube plus b cube. And in denominator, you have a square plus b square minus ab. Yep. Now, this a cube plus b cube, if you know the property, we can rewrite it as a plus b into a square plus b square minus ab. This a square plus b square minus ab get cancelled out with each other, and finally you get answer as a plus b. Now let's have a look at this question. As I said earlier, this question is bit different than earlier question. You can see in numerator the term given is 5.75, whereas in denominator it's 57.5. Let's call 5.75 in numerator as a. If we have a in a numerator, then in denominator also we should have a. So for that, what we need to do, we will simply divide our denominator by 100 and we will also multiply it by 100. After this, my denominator will be 5.75 into 5.75 plus 3.25, because we are dividing by 100, into 3.25 minus 5.75 into 3.25 and multiplied by 100. Let me explain you this concept with the simple example. Let's say we have a term a into b. If I divide it by 100 and multiply it by 100, it will be still the same term. Now I can rewrite as 100 into, so a by this 100, it will be 0.a and b will be 0.b, right? So in the similar way, we have transformed our denominator. Let's quickly solve this question. So we'll have 5.75 as a. Okay, so I can write it as a cube because it's 3 times, right? Plus 3.25 is my b, I can write it as b cube. Divide it by 100 times. Okay, so let's have a look at this denominator. Simplified denominator, we can write a square plus b square minus a b. I hope you got it, because we have assumed 5.75 as a and 3.25 as b. Now simply solve this question. As we learned earlier, like a cube plus b cube is a plus b into a square plus b square minus ab. Okay, and this denominator will be 100 times a square plus b square minus ab. Now this a square plus b square minus ab will cancel it out, and eventually our answer would be a plus b divided by 100. Now what's the value of a and b? A is 5.75 whereas b is 3.25. Yep. So let's write it down. 5.75 plus 3.25, let's divide it by 100. Let's add the numerator. 5 plus 3, 8. 0.75, 0.25 will be 1, so 8 plus 1, 9, divided by 100. So our answer will be 0.09. I hope you got the trick to deal with such kind of question. Thank you very much for watching.